Hey guys, today on Extreme Country Outdoor Talk, we're going to talk about the biggest fish we've ever caught and the biggest fish we've lost. So, I'll start us off, Jack will go next. So, okay, the biggest fish I've caught was at a local pond of mine that I've been fishing for about 3 years now, three, four, and Jack's been there like once. So, first thing would happen is that day is during spawn, they're all in their beds, and I'm just kind of fishing this morning about a 1 pounder on a bed. So we don't really have the best, biggest fish in Utah. So I was going for a 1 pounder with a shaky head, and I was just going at it, just giving it a little tap. He kind of just hit it a little bit. And then some weird kid walks up to me and he goes, "Hey dude, there's some giant bass over there, dude, like King Kong." So I just whip over there, I kind of walk into his spot. And then I was like, I looked at the bass and I was like, wow, that's a PB right there. I just start kind of casting. I'm like, sorry, dude, I won't take your spot. I'll just take one more cast. I throw my little shaky head in. Okay, I get ready and I'm just kind of looking and I'm like, oh, sorry, dude, and we're talking. And I just go, and I lay into him with my ugly stick and my fluger. And the kid was kind of a clown. He started going into the water, like, he put his foot all in the water, got all muddy, all this crap. He got my fish, and it was a pretty big fish. Biggest fish I've lost, so, yeah, this is a good story. Good lake of mine that me and Jack have been fishing for a long time. I was over there with him on a boat, and we had a nice net. We were fishing with some power bait, and, I just kind of saw a little bite going, picked up my rod, hooked into it, started reeling in, King Kong slot buster, and Jack has some little plier things, what are they called?
Fish grippers.
Fish grippers, yep. Okay, where you just put it on the lip and lift out. Well, we had a perfect net on the boat, and Jack decides, I'm going to test these out. So he keeps trying to whack him with it and get it, and well, the kid was just kind of a clown, and the fish just kind of started swimming away, yep. So.
That was a rough one.
King Kong.
Okay, let's hear it. Okay, so one of my biggest fish that I've ever caught was a big saltbuster cutthroat up at a great lake, and it was really, really big, very first saltbuster I ever caught, and I caught him on a shadow wrap, and I was jerking it a little bit, reeling it in really, really nice, so bam, and I hooked up, the giant was on. I knew it was, because, like, it was arching, and I got him into the bank, and I started to like rip on him, and he was a big fish, like way big, and I got him up to the bank and held him up, and yeah, that's basically the biggest one that I've caught. He was a really big cutthroat. I'll show you a picture of that right there. And the biggest fish that I lost. Well, I was fishing. If I was to redo this all over again, guys, I did a lot of dumb stuff, but I was fishing by myself with my Rapala shadow wrap, and I was casting it on the shore, and I was going along the bank, and I just kept going along, and I got to this spot where there's like the big point, and like the current came in this way, and there's like a current coming this way, and it was like a weird spot to fish with, and there was snow on the ground. I was on like a big rock, and I casted right into the spot, started jerking it, and started playing around with my lure, and I start reeling it in nice and slow, bam, I hooked up on a giant, guys, big fish, and I started reeling in him, got him all the way up, and then behind this fish, okay, the one that I already have on is a tank, okay, like, big fish, the one behind the fish was King Kong, like, the head on this thing was, like, this big, biggest cutthroat trout I've ever saw in my life, huge fish, dude, chasing the big fish that I had hooked in, and I don't know if he was either going after my lure because he was mad the other fish took it, or if he was trying to eat the other fish. I don't know.
I think it was the lure.
And he was nipping at it though, and like trying to get the tail. And I was in the moment by myself, not a net, not a measuring tape, not any fish grippers, nothing. I was just, I don't know what to put it as, but I was being a clown. We'll just put it like that. But okay, so I started to get him up to the bank, and I had this perfect sandy beach area over here where I could have just drug my fish up in a happy person, you know. But instead, I thought, oh, I'm going to get it up on this big old rock. So I just went, and then, like, when the fish was sloshing around, he had one treble in his mouth, one on his fin, and he's sloshing around in the water, and I tried to pull him up on the shore. I know, it's a little dumb, but I tried pulling him up on the shore, and it ripped right through his jaw. And I jumped in the lake, holding him, and I was like, oh, shoot. And then he swarms, and
boy, he just got hooked out, right?
Gone.
Yeah. He just swarmed?
He just, like, treble hook ripped through his jaw. And then, like, he swarmed all over me and just gone. Like, the fish slime is just, you know, can't even hold him.
And
I was in the water, which is kind of dumb, but.
And it's freezing temps.